The history will be made today, and again it's between the two protagonists who have been at the center of the annual war which has been the schoolboy football season over the last few years. They battle for the ISA Champions Cup for the first time, Kingston College seeking to become the first team to win it twice against Clarendon College aiming to claim it for the very first time. Last season they were the kings of their respective urban and rural era competitions and fought to see who the best in the land was in the Olivia Shield. They meet again, albeit in a different competition, playing for this trophy, with quite a few thinking this should be the true symbol of schoolboy football supremacy in Jamaica. Warm conditions here at the National Stadium, 28 degrees Celsius, and it's a bit windy as well. And we do expect a good game of football, with the rains expected to stay away. Wherever you're watching from all over the world, thank you so much for joining our coverage here on the Home of Champions. My name is Donald Oliver. With me is Dwight Jeremiah. He's eager ahead of this match as well.
Eager as if I'm a player, Donald. I'm very excited about today. I just want to revel in this spectacle that is about to unfold before our eyes in a short moment. And I expect good football from these two teams. There's enough motivation for these two teams to go all out and try and win it today. Not let alone that it is a finals. But when we look at it, you have Kingston College, who this game signals the end of their 2019 schoolboy football season and their only chance of lifting silverwares this season. So in that respect, you feel they have that motivation for Clarendon College. They would be looking to win the only schoolboy football trophy that they can win but has never won. So it's showing that there's enough underlying motivation for these two teams.
Well, Chapelton and North Street have borne the expectation of this matchup for a week. And the mecca of Jamaica's football is now a cauldron for the gladiatorial schoolboy conflict. The best attacking force from the rural area against the best defensive rock among urban area schools. Kingston College hoping to end the season with a flamboyant hurrah. Clarendon College eager to reign in a prestigious triple crown, which has been done only once by the Jamaica College team of 2014. The dream ends for one tonight, a more clear future for the victor. Kingston College, of course, in their traditional purple and white this evening. And of course, Clarendon College donned in their blue and yellow numbers. They're going to be missed. They're going to be met by the party led by the ISA president, Keith Wellington. And of course, O'Neill Antle is also there. As well as a host of sponsors to meet both teams. First Kingston College, and then he'll come across to the reigning rural era champions, Clarendon College. Kingston College, of course, being dethroned of the Manning Cup just a few days ago, having lost on penalties to Jamaica College. And with the Brave having fallen in this match, will they rise in this final? That's the question being asked. And we are a few minutes away from the kickoff, and everyone eagerly anticipating this matchup. Said initially that's a matchup probably between attack and defense, but you have to give Kingston College the credit as well. They do have a brilliant attacking force. It all depends how the likes of Dwayne Atkinson will be utilized up front by Ludlow Bernard. We pause now for the playing of the national anthem. We're inching ever closer and closer to the battle. The formalities will end with the handshakes of the team members, the officials right there as well. And all this will give way to a fight. They met in the Olivia Shield last year. Clarendon College left it late to win that contest here at the National Stadium. Andre Nicholson was a scorer back then. Kingston College, they have a few players missing and they have to compromise their starting 11. We'll get to that in short order. But right now, the toss. Rashid Gavin is a skipper for Kingston College. Earl Simpson wears the captain's armband for Clarendon College. Danion Parchment will be in charge of this one, assisted by Nicholas Anderson. And we'll take a look at the Clarendon College starting lineup. Prince Daniel Smith is in goal for Clarendon College. A back four of Omar Reed, Richard King, Earl Simpson and Jamari Howell. Tajay Williams, David Chambers and Jaheim Rose, they are in the middle of the park. And up top, Jalen Larmond, Roderick Granville and Sheldon Smart, who has scored 13 goals so far this season.
And they play this 4-4-3-3 formation. And that infamous front three of Smart, Larmond, and Granville. Those are the players that are going to really test this rock watertight Kingston College defense.
Every player, with the exception of the goalkeeper, on the score chart. That's how Lenny Hyde likes it. That's how he sets it up for this team. This is Kingston College going over the last words. As we take a look at their starting lineup. David Martin is in goal. In front of him, Rajiv Gavin, the skipper, Calvin Gardner there, Sajar Blair, and Michael Allen being asked to play in a wing-back role. Chris Pearson is in the middle of the park. Jamar Morrison isn't there. Damari McCarthy, Scott McLeod complete the midfield three. Up top, Ronaldo Robinson, Dwayne Atkinson, and of course, Tyrese Williams. Atkinson with 18 goals so far this season. Williams with 9.
Also, at Kingston College, they do play the 4-3-3 formation, but what's going to be interesting to see is how Coach Bernard employs Atkinson and Robinson, because we've seen where they've been employed very deep just to stop those passing lanes from the teams that like Clarendon, who likes to pass this ball. He's going to have to try and find the right balance between attack and defense today, Coach Bernard.
The official word from Kingston College is that he's just been given a rest. Kingston College being asked to change their gears. They had on jerseys with different sponsors' names on the front, and so the change had to be made ahead of the kickoff.
That's just adding to what is to come in terms of delaying a little bit, but the excitement about to unfold before our eyes. And as I said before, these are two teams with very talented and gifted players amongst their ranks. Two teams with very experienced and tactically astute coaches who knows how to and really likes to win. And two teams that can enter into any conversation when we talk about top school boy football teams, present and past, because you're talking about Clarendon College and Kingston College. As soon as we get those out of the way, then for sure, we can't wait for the excitement on the park.
Robinson College. They also have white tapings on their socks as well. And you think that would have been, at least that would have been spotted by the referees as well before the start of the game. I just don't get why these things happen ahead of a major final. I don't understand.
Yeah, it's right, because the rule, as it states, even if they cut the socks, as FIFA is saying, the under socks would still have to be of the same color. So probably makes no sense. You want to cut it just the same. But yeah, they would not be allowed, or should not be allowed. And do you feel they would have checked them off in the rooms before coming out? Well, the assessments for the referees, they will deal with that after all of this.
Well, I hope this doesn't set the tone for the entire game, and that the players will live up to the initial billing of this contest, because life has a way of doing that to you.
Yes, a lot of times we see the big finals, we anticipate great excitement and a lot of entertainment, and because so much rides on a game, and that tactical astuteness of these coaches tend to sometimes just stifle the natural ability of these players. Well, Coach Leonard Hyde, he said, well, he was always an attacking player, and that's what he coaches most of the times with his team. It's all about a lot of attack. They are still good, a defensive unit, but his ploy is once he has the ball, then it's a form of attack and defense, because the opponent cannot hurt you.
They continue to do their checks, and we're about 10 minutes late from the initial kickoff, because television, of course, isn't that important. Mentioned before that Kingston College would be a more defensive-minded team, but Clarendon College, they haven't been letting in the goals, have they, in recent times?
No, they have not been, and I think a lot of that has to do with the fact that for the most part in a game, they control possession, they have the bulk of it, and that, as I said earlier, it acts as a form of defense, because your opponent can't hurt you if they don't have the football, and a lot of times we see when one team dominates the possession and the other one gets it, they tend not to use it so well, being out of possession for so long, chasing around. So I think that is part and parcel of why Clarendon College has not conceded a lot. I mean, but they're still a good team, organized without the football. If you see them, as minute they lose the football, it's almost an instantaneous transition from attack to defense, and they press you very high up the park, and they close the park, the passing lane. So they're a very good unit. But still with Kingston College, and we talk about their defense, but as it stands, they have some players in their ranks that, if employed in the right way, can really hurt or trouble this Clarendon College team. You lay this delay squarely and solely at the feet of the officials who would have checked the teams off before they would have come out.
And all the KC players, their mental state will be now, having G'd up for the start of this one, and then almost having to reset ahead of kickoff.
I tell you one thing, once first whistle goes and the ball gets rolling, I suspect they'll be ready. It's too much of a big game for Kingston College, like I said. It's the game which marks the end of their 2019 season and their only chance of lifting silverware. So it's massive for Kingston College.
The thing is, these jerseys are worse for wear ahead of this final, but again, we'll leave that one alone.
The less said about that, the better.
about a quarter of an hour late, but here we go for the ISA Champions Cup final. Kingston College in their full white, Clarendon College in the traditional blue, along with the yellow stripes. White stripes, I should say, with the yellow numbers. How will KOC respond after that delay? Here they are in the middle of the park. McCarthy lost it out to Granville, who's been a workhorse for Clarendon College, hasn't he? The number 14.
Yeah, he is, and he's such an unselfish and willing runner, always down that flank.
Think about this Clarendon College team as well. They're probably the fittest team in the country. And that would be thanks to their coach, Junior Samuels. The paces that he puts them through on a regular basis, especially in preseason, has set the course for them being a running side for the majority of this season. And Lenny Hyde, of course, likes working with him. Of course, he's usually in the spotlight, Leonard Teacher Hyde. And Junior Samuels, he doesn't mind being out of the spotlight.
And that's why this Clarendon College team, they'll play to the very end, the very last whistle, because for the most part, they have enough energy even when the game goes into the final stages, because they use the football so well.
Dudley Bernard has a lot on his mind. No Lewis Watson to call on at left back this evening. Still has the eye injury he picked up against JC. Not seeing well, having headaches as well. Lewis Watson, of course, he's the son of the assistant coach, Raymond Watson.
I hope that that does not cause him to have the likes of Dwayne Atkinson playing very deep. Prefer if he would visit that left back position rather than be in it too often.
Shot from distance, not a lot of pace on it. And of course, his replacement in that game against JC, Khalifa Richards. Well, he has been under some mental strain since that biting incident, based on what has been taking place on social media. And the coaching staff deemed that he wasn't up to scratch to at least start in this one.
Well, I suspect in a way he would be. He did come on and show good footballing skills going forward, was a good outlet for them going forward. But he's not in the... I think they just want to take him out of the firing line. Mentally might not have been up to par for this encounter today.
Tyrese Williams trying to utilize his speed along that far side. Earl Simpson is with him all the way. Ball going out into touch. Dwayne Atkinson again, he's being asked to support his midfield. And it's been a while that he has been off his game, Dwayne Atkinson. The number 13 for KC.
We do see that a lot from Coach Bernard, employing him so deep. I feel it just takes a little bit away, well, a lot away, because he's such a talented player, from the impetus going forward. But we heard him, and you know his mindset is such that he feels that he's up against a team that really picks those passing lanes very well, shift the ball around and move people out of places, just want to not have enough bodies behind the ball. Somehow that transition is going to have to be quicker tonight, because the likes of Atkinson and Robinson, you feel, better served further up the park. he would be pleased, Coach Bernard, with the fact that his setup is similar, much the same way in the last two games they have played. Didn't allow him to concede a lot, but what it did, didn't allow him to win the games in regular time.
Clarendon College, they haven't really been in the attacking third so far in this encounter.
Well, it's never easy, no matter how much you're a passing team and you have good technical players. Always difficult with 10 or 11 players behind the ball a lot of times when you pick it up. Gonna have to be patient, but we've seen this Clarendon College team play a different styles and are effective against opponents who even play different styles as well.
Not to mention the fact that they're, well, especially in the past few games, renowned slow starters. Started slow against McGrath, against Cornwall College.
That's correct, Donald Day. And they're a very good team when it comes on to the second half. A lot of goals they scored. A lot.
Have we not registered a goal in the first half especially? But they have picked it up in the second half and shown the results. But here they are, coming forward. He's offside, isn't he? The flag goes up. He was offside by about a mile there.
Yes. Jess was so enthused about his run there at Granville. But we're going to see a lot of that. Definitely offside there. Easy call for the assistant on this near side. But Granville always provides that width for Clarendon College and allow them to pass that ball through the channel. Splitting the defence as we see their number six, Clarendon College, rose on the turf. But yes, Granville is very good at providing width way up the park, and it's going to be a crucial player for them today.
Clarendon College trying to get into their own. Larman there in the picture, applying the pressure.
They have not been bad from set pieces this season either, Clarendon College.
Even if they are scoring directly from them.
Yes, most definitely.
And Omar Reid has done so far this season.
You remember that one against the Wolmers.
And he's the one who's going to be taking this one. All hands on deck for KC in defence. This one sent in at the back post, and Martin saw it all the way. Wasn't going to be fooled.
No, he was looking to do the same thing, but I think Martin had positioned himself more closer to the back post.
Williams, oh, nice work. Pulls it up back on Ronaldo Robinson with a clear-cut opportunity. Totally miskicked.
The best opportunity so far in this encounter.
Here they are again. This one cut back inside. The shot by Pearson is a weak one. Two big chances for Kingston College. And, well, the results left a lot to be desired.
It's a good cut back by Blair. And this here, good ball inside, and Robinson just had a missed kick, and it wasn't his strongest foot. But good to see. So many players, sometimes they don't take the opportunities when they do come. He was looking to have a swing with his right, not his strongest.
Lola Bernard speaking to his holding midfielder, Demario McCarthy. Just issuing instructions. Lenny Hyde speaking to Roderick Granville. There's goalkeeper Prince Daniel Smith getting some attention. The gathering building here at the National Stadium.
I remember Coach Ida saying that his team in his last encounter here against Cornwall College wasn't pleased because they weren't consistent in their display. Plays in patches sometimes. But you do hope Kingston College don't live to regret those two missed chances.
Smart. Tajay Williams, Earl Simpson. DC just tried to move it along quickly there.
And that's going to have to be a feature of their game today. The fact that they have a lot of the attacking players a little bit deeper than normal. That movement or transition has to be quick.
CC moving forward. A chance for Granville. Held on to it a little bit too long. Omar Reed picks it up, utilizing his pace. Heads to the byline. Two players to aim for. And it's put behind for a corner kick by Kingston College.
Beautiful pace shown by Reed here. Lovely ball inside of the box and Smart waiting. Crucial interception there.
Has to be retaken. Jalen Larman to deliver from the far side for Clarendon College. This one sent in at the near post, headed away. Larman should get there, he does. Tajay Williams. Nice work in getting by Allen, but he lost it. And KC can counter. Tyrese Williams on it, plays it forward. One in the middle. Couldn't find him, it's put behind. Ronaldo Robertson had to do better there to locate Dwayne Atkinson, who was making camp on the penalty spot.
Really love the run of Atkinson too. He arrived a bit late and you could see him picking up his speed just as it was about to be delivered to him. Good ball, just needed to find him there.
Corner kick taken quickly, McCarthy. Delivery inside. Pearson. Lost it. Granville. Challenge coming in. CC trying to press. Granville gets the ball over the top. Not a lot of players up for CC. David Chambers. His pass was charged down and Tyrese Williams lost an opportunity there. Here they come, Kingston College through Dwayne Atkinson on his right foot, plays it to the top of the D. Williams looking for space to shoot. Oh, it's wide of the mark. He is still searching for his 10th, the boy from Rima.
It's a good play here from Kingston College. And you talk about the speed in transition. Atkinson at the heart of it. And you felt just at that moment, Williams was going to atone for the fact that he missed a chance to play in. Atkinson earlier just dragged his shot wide. But we have a proper a football match before us, Donald.
CC's turn to respond. Again, the long ball over the top. KC defense standing firm. Gavin sends it to McCarthy. Gavin retrieving, not the best clearance, and that was the best pass forward. and it's deja vu again as CC with it. Over on that far side, there was a hint of offside there. In the end, CC, they give up the possession.
On that occasion, King didn't make the run. We spoke about at the beginning of this one that Kingston College would have to find the right balance with attack and defense. It seems they've worked something out.
Chance for Smart. Oh, he does brilliantly. Smart on his right. Setting up Chambers across the Granville, who was always under pressure to get off an accurate shot.
It's just in the blink of an eye. Cannon College. Just a turnover in possession here, and a Smart, lovely footwork, cutting inside. And Chambers, you feel that ball just a little bit away from Granville. Always a stretching, just at the point to make contact. And didn't manage to wrap his foot around it.
Atkinson gets in the way. Runs forward.
In that play just now, I just felt Atkinson didn't have enough options left and right. Movement came late from the two players ahead of him, and both players ended up to his right.
Clarendon College, they are desperate to win this trophy for the first time, aren't they? Coaching staff, the management, pushing their players from the sidelines.
They really want it, Donald. They spoke about it pre-match interviews.
Jaheim Rose, poor ball. Harsh challenge, and the yellow card comes out to Omar Reed, and he cannot believe that he was shown the card for the infringement.
We'll look at it there, yeah. A bit late, and yeah, I don't think he should have much complaint about that. And then also at times referees, when I have words with them, they do talk about, they look to at which player that type of tackle may go up against, because they do know that teams are well aware of the danger players on the opposing side, and sometimes they're out to make their lives difficult. Sometimes they exercise too much force.
Dental Technical having a look at Clarendon College before they meet them in the Lacustical final next week, Saturday. Ball set inside the box, and Prince Daniel Smith holding on, distributing out to Granville. Nodded it away into safety. There's a Sajar player.
That's another thing we talk about with this Clarendon College team. They do play different ways. Short passes, yes, but they're not averse to playing those long balls over the top, especially when they know that their opponent has just committed a lot of players forward. Let's talk about playing in an intelligent way, not just sticking to that short passing game all the time.
Chambers. Simpson. Reed. Trying to find Smart. CC starting again from the back. Reed has it. Williams, that wasn't the best back pass, was it? Prince Daniel Smith mopping up.
Almost selling his goalkeeper shot there.
Tajay Williams. Keeper coming off his line and will get there. Ahead of Jalen Larman.
That's a little bit too straight, that pass. Needed a little bit more diagonal to have given Larman a better chance.
Here's Larman again. Now he gives up the ball. Casey's turn to go the other way. And another ball goes astray. King to Simpson, his captain. Omar Reed again looking for the diagonal ball to Granville. It's accurate on this occasion.
A beautiful ball from Reed to Granville. Like I said, they play that ball as a part of their army, as well as they play it short and get the players coming, and then they go and play it long.
Tyrese Williams, that's a nice first touch. Sajar Blair gets it, heads to the byline, pulls it across, stabbed away. McCarthy does well.
Smart, they're doing well. Such a good technical player. Holds it up so well. And
Chambers has it for CC. Play is down and he needs some urgent attention. And what happened there? He's holding his hand, wondering if there's a dislocated finger, and it seems that there is. Well, the players around him are grimacing. Not sure if he landed awkwardly on his hand. Ooh. Ooh. Oh my. Oh my goodness. Oh, they have lost their captain, Rajiv Gavin. It's his arm. Or oh, it's Tyrese Williams, sorry, not Rajiv Gavin. Their striker is out for the game with a, was that a dislocated elbow?
It looks away, it looks very disturbing. I hope it's nothing too. He will recover in time. We wish him a speedy recovery there, but it seems like he went down very hard on it and might have just broken
his hand.
We hope that they can lift themselves, Kingston College, from this, because very horrific there. Not something you want to see happening to any player.
KC players couldn't even look.
Yeah, I saw Prince Daniel Smith just holding his head when he had a look.
Ajay Stewart is coming on. Replacing Tyrese Williams. And that injury has surely shaken up the KC community. How will they bounce back? clear. Had the options to provide the pass earlier.
Yes, could have slipped in the substitute. Jay Stewart on that occasion.
Atkinson. Being a nuisance. And Omar Reed did well enough.
He did very well here, Donald. Saint Atkinson tried to get one by him, and once Reed got possession of it, trusting himself so well, not the type of player that's going to just try and boot it out. Looking to try and set himself up to retain possession. Here we see confirmation of the fact that Tyrese Williams to be forced a substitution there, and Jay Stewart replacing him.
Omar Reed was also at the center of a scare in a televised match recently when he just fell untouched.
Yeah, I remember that one, really a bit concerned, because it always is when a player just goes down without any contact.
Robinson winning the header to Pearson. Nice turn from Robinson. Referee calling back the play as there was a foul from Larman.
In this opening 28 minutes of this encounter, certainly Clarendon College not having it their own way. We didn't expect it in our finals. Kingston College has certainly make their contribution to this spectacle that we're having before us. Certainly done well, Kingston College.
It's going to be Chris Pearson to deliver this one.
It's too much on that one from Pearson. Didn't give his players that have committed themselves forward any chance. He felt he needed to serve it right towards the penalty spot area just to give them a chance, but sailing over. Clarendon College not allowed to just pass themselves out of the back. They're certainly witnessing a good football match.
Pearson. Lovely ball up front. Shot taken off the post. And another attempt is blocked. But Ronaldo Robinson cannot believe his luck or lack of it, because he fired that one in. And the upright was in the way.
It was a beautiful ball too from Pearson. Lovely ball that split the defense. And just a toe poke there, because always under pressure to execute that almost to perfection.
That was close for KC. This one sent long at the back post. Headed. Wasn't heading much further away, was it? Michael Allen or Sajar Blair has it.
And on that attempt just now, Prince Daniel Smith was rooted to the spot. He just prayed to the heavens that it didn't go in.
throw taken. Clearance made. Jamari Howell doing the work at the back. They give it up in a dangerous spot. Spot would have been offside if the ball had gone through.
What this must be concerning for Clarendon College is just the fact that in that final third, just not getting that final pass, the accuracy that we expect from them.
Casey having the majority of the possession, I think, so far in this one. They've had the best chance too. And Robinson was at the center of it. 46-54.
And Donald, it's not just possession for Kingston College for possession's sake. They've really, really been testing this Clarendon College unit with their possession. Coach Bernard willing them to press up high, do not allow them to pass out.
Now Ronaldo Robinson requires some attention from the bench. Kingston College, they've already lost one player.
And it's one of the attacking three. They would not want to lose another of that front three.
Broke his arm, Tyrese Williams. A shock for everyone around him on the field, as well as I'm sure those watching in TV land.
It's not a sight that you want to see in.
We do wish him a speedy recovery, Tyrese Williams. Not the way he would have wanted to end his season. Of course, his team can still do something positive for him tonight in becoming the first team to win the Champions Cup trophy twice.
Sometimes those things, though horrific they are and disappointing, it can be used as motivation, and persons have done that.
Reed goes down, play continues. Long ball over the top, Sheldon Smart is there, the keeper is off his line, does well to head it away. Chambers trying to win it back. Heads to the byline, and did that cross the line? David Martin did well.
It did very well, Donald. To anticipate, come off his line, it was outside the box, couldn't hold it, had to head that one.
Dwayne Atkinson is there, trying to break three from his defender. Atkinson to shoot, he skies it.
That occasion, I felt he could have taken on the Clarendon College skipper in Earl Simpson, and really a 1v1 situation there. Good serve coming from just a mistake there from King. Well, not.
It was the captain, Simpson.
It was the captain,
yes. College would have conceded just once in their last six matches. and that was against St. Andrew Technical High School, who are now in the final of the Manning Cup, where they will face Jamaica College.
They have come closest in this game to concede a goal, Clarendon College. One hit in the post from Andrew Robinson. You feel Kingston College would want to take their chances in this first half, and they have created the better. Because we've seen Clarendon College in the second half.
Robinson's dink! Just too far in front of Atkinson.
And I spoke about these two players when we spoke about their formation and the fact that we'd want to see them employed further up the park. And that's where they get a lot of joy. That's where they show their prowess in this encounter. They're doing just that.
Robinson tried to stay on his feet, couldn't. Play called back. Free kick for Kingston College.
And get the shackles are released here. Remonstrating there that he needed players to come back, Omar Reed, to help out, because a part of that 4-3-3 system, he wants to ensure that his other players are tracking back, those wide strikers are tracking back to help out.
Pearson to go long. Clearance by CC.
And that came from Larman. As we can see, Kingston College having a lot to shout about. Fans in the stands really having a good time. They should be loving what they're seeing from their team.
Quite a few former players in the stands as well. Granville.
Just not as slick as they normally are at Clarendon College, but give credit to Kingston College. They are part of the reason why.
Oh no, they've lost it in a dangerous area. It's set up for Pearson. Well, he took forever to get a shot off. Stewart. Oh, that's a delightful ball. Atkinson back to Pearson, who skies it.
I think that might have been the reason why it took so long the first time to shoot, because maybe not having the confidence to strike at goal, as we saw with that attempt from him there. It's good work from Kingston College. Through their substitute there, getting it to Atkinson, and once he teed it up for Pearson, always leaning back, not showing the type of confidence to lean into that one and strike at goal. And like I said earlier, Kingston College, they have been presented with the best opportunities in this game.
If I'm not mistaken, I think Pearson had been suffering from a leg injury for parts of the season. Can't recall if it was his knee or his ankle, but they got an indication that he was favoring something after he took the shot. And that could point to his hesitation when Leandro Bernard is absolutely animated on the sidelines.
He didn't like the challenge coming in from Ronaldo Robinson. Reed is a very important player for Clarendon, and Coach Hyde will not want to lose him in this one.
Again, the long ball upfield. Lost the trajectory of it, did Roger Granville.
I felt so done, and I felt he was favored to win it once the pass was made.
Well, I think he just lost the ball in the air. He just stopped running, and then it just went out of his reach.
And even when he attempted again, he was still with a good chance. So you can just imagine that he continued to move towards it. But as we've seen so often with Clarendon College, maybe on the siege, but when they do get an opportunity, normally clinical, Kingston College will want to, would love to go into the half with a lead. They would certainly deserve it if they were to do so.
Remember, Clarendon College, they haven't been beaten at all this season.
Not at all, and I was just about to say to when we came into this encounter, as we see challenge there from a Gardner. But I was saying, we were talking about attack against defense and the fact that Kingston College having the best defensive record, but they have been good value for their attacking intent today.
Larmond skips inside. Smart, wasn't really expecting it, and lost possession.
You feel he should have been, because Larmond, he went inside. He's the natural wide player. He looked to make his run inside, you suspect. Smart would also know his next move would be to make a move outside into that wide channel. Just turned his back to it, didn't open his body up when he went outside, and took his eye off the ball and wasn't able to help that move from Clarendon College. Suspect he'll get it right as the game goes, and he's normally good with his off the ball movement. Smart. But I feel too for Larmond, Clarendon College will have to get him involved a lot more in the attacking third. Haven't seen a lot from him in this opening 43 minutes.
Such our player. Trying to find Atkinson, who's against Omar Reed again. Atkinson trying to get by Reed. And Granville doing good work. But they've lost it in a critical area. Atkinson heads to the byline. And he wins the corner for his team.
Thought that was a poor clearance from Clarendon College. Had the option to play it wide to Granville. Just didn't do that and just played it right back into traffic. You feel they're the architect of their own problems just now, Clarendon College.
Here's a corner kick. Sent high inside the box. Cleared away. CC, can they counter? Larmond was fouled. Yellow card comes out to such our player. Daniel Parchman saying that he knew exactly what he was doing.
And I think he's correct with that. I just moments ago spoke about the fact that Clarendon College need to get Larmond involved. Hadn't seen him enough. And we see what happened when he's involved in the attacking third. He creates panic. Always a dangerous player, Larmond, creating panic there for defenders. The Clarendon College will have to get him, like I say, more on that football.
And Blair has to be careful for the rest of the game now. Based on how limited their squad is, Blair will be playing the 90 minutes for Kingston College, you'd think.
Most definitely.
Omar Reed is known for the spectacular. He's the one behind this free kick. Kingston College and David Martin have set up the three-man wall. Omar Reed drives it into the wall. Sula Chads. Referee has called the play back for a Kingston College free kick. And you felt that they were poised to get on the break there.
Talking to Reed there, and remember, Reed is on a yellow card as well. So he will want to be careful. And he felt once the rebound came off the wall, he should have been looking to just serve it back into the box, because he still had a lot of players committed that way. And you felt why he had to commit the foul in the end, is that had he lost it there, and you feel that Kingston College could have had numbers up going forward.
Ball punted long, looking for Atkinson. Prince Daniel Smith collects. Couldn't quite contain the pass, Granville.
On that occasion, probably not the best technique used.
Almost got through, almost.
And it would have been interesting had it done so.
Blair with a throw. Corner kick for KC. With just about a minute remaining in stoppage time. With their band playing "You're Gonna Hear Me Roar," what can they do with this set piece? Kingston College, they've put a few bodies upfield, six inside the penalty area. Clarendon College, all bar one inside the penalty box. Pearson to deliver. He needs to be accurate. Here's the delivery at the near post. Easily handled. Another chance to deliver. Christopher Pearson sends it high, and it's not cleared properly, and the skipper puts it over the top. Rajiv Gavin, looking for his third this season, got too much underneath that one.
He's definitely felt, he probably got excited when he sees just falling to his feet there. Goalkeeper Smith didn't deal with it, the initial one, very well. Just palm it down into the danger area. And you felt another glorious opportunity there for Kingston College to take the lead in this first half. But there ends the first half, and they go in all level.
Yep. It's been a good game. The first 44 minutes, we've seen a keen contest. We've seen a horrific injury for Kingston College and their striker, Tyrese Williams. Clarendon College, they've had few opportunities. Kingston College, they've had the better chances. But we are yet to see a goal in this Champions Cup finale here at the Mecca of Jamaica's football. It is Clarendon College nil. Champions Cup finale, Clarendon College against Kingston College. We're yet to see a goal, Dwight Jeremiah. And that may change in the second half, as both teams, you would think, will up the tempo.
You suspect that they have to, more so Clarendon College. They did not deliver as expected of them in the first half. But we know second half, they really are a team that tend to go up a notch or several notches, and so we expect that they will test Kingston College a lot more, and we, Kingston College, will hope that they do not live to rue the chances that they missed in that first half. Even that last chance that fell to the captain, in all fairness to him, came to him quickly, but was always going to have to take the shot very quickly as well.
And he's not a striker.
I always say, once you get into the box, then you make yourself into someone who we expect to finish. But yeah, you're right, Donald. Not with the best technique or instinct in the box, but you know, it showed that Kingston College, in the initial stages, I was looking to see how would Coach Bernard employs him, display his charges today, and I was quite pleased to see the likes of Atkinson and Robinson in a more advanced role for a lot of that first half. And it showed that maybe sometimes you have to release the shackle and allow your gifted and talented players to express themselves, and they did cause Clarendon College a lot of problems in that first half.
Shazar Blair getting loose once more. The referee is making their way out back to the middle. Gideon Parchment, of course, the man in charge.
High-profile team of referees, FIFA officials, they are quite fitting for an encounter like this. Gideon Parchment, from the parish of Trelawney as well. Just got back on the island.
How many referees come from Trelawney?
We are blessed with some good FIFA and CONCACAF officials. We saw three of them recently in the Manning Cup semi-finals, and Damien Parchment just got back from some friendlies overseas. So yes, Trelawney does have a good cadre of officials in terms of FIFA and CONCACAF.
So not just Usain Bolt, not just Veronica Campbell-Brown, not just Dwight Jeremiah.
No. I wonder why you put me in that category. But I'm happy that you did so.
I couldn't think of anybody else, actually. That was the primary issue.
I did that, Donald.
Of course, Kingston College, they lost one of their players, Tyrese Williams, with a broken hand. It was a horrific injury. And you have to wonder their mental state coming out for the second half, having possibly heard the news from the management as to exactly what happened, but they would have seen the gruesome injury. Can they put that behind them as they start this second half? They'll be kicking towards the hills. Clarendon College will be kicking towards the Caribbean Sea.
I think if you were Coach Bernard, you'd be telling Kingston College more of the same. As for Clarendon College, they need to get their attacking wide players on the ball a lot more. And their midfield need to come into play as well.
See, Kingston College starting out the half, pressing a little bit higher. Smart, trying to send that one wide. Chambers collects, forced to go wide, decides not to take on Sajar Blair. Clarendon College trying to make this field as wide as possible. But they need to be a little bit more accurate in the final third, Clarendon College.
More so, yes, Donald, you're right. In the attacking third, in the midfield as well. Lots of turnovers in the first half. They're going to have to put that right as well in this second half.
Of course, they are not afraid to build from the back. This is King. Chambers with it. Williams. Simpson. They've been plugging the gaps, Kingston College.
Yeah, they've been doing well and getting behind the ball and blocking those passing lanes, not allowing Clarendon College with their possession to have too many penetrating passes. But I suspect Coach Hyde would also have told them at halftime just to be a little bit more patient. I don't think they had shown that patience in that first half as much as they should to move it around a lot more.
Reed finding Larmond. Back to Chambers. Delivers inside. The header is over the top.
It's a good ball in there. Just got under it too much. Clarendon College number 6, Jaheim Rose. But we see there when the wide players like Larman, as we said, wasn't on the ball enough in that second half. He was involved there just now.
Well, it's going to be a foul on Smart.
And neatly, smartly got his body between man and ball. They're forcing the defender to go through him.
Sold it a little too, Sheldon Smart.
Coach Hyde, he'll be looking to see if the boys have displaying that which he would have asked of them. The halftime interval.
Sajar Blair to throw it long. five players inside the box for KC. Robinson, no problems there for Prince Daniel Smith. Smart, lost it. Allen has it, has some space to work with. Pearson skips by one, couldn't get by a second. KC still with it. Only just. He did well there, the captain.
With a little
Earl
luck.
Simpson. Yeah, with a bit of luck, you're right. Granville. Rose. Trying to go through by himself. Wasn't successful. Now Pearson. Atkinson was charged down immediately by Richard King. And he puts in a challenge himself. This case he's number 13. And CC's number 14.
They're just creating problems for themselves, Cam, in college. There we saw there. Rose had an opportunity to pass to Chambers and just chose to go on his own, even when he was closed down by two players. So yes, Kingston College, they are doing a number on Clarendon College in the middle of the park, just trying to crowd them out. But they too, Clarendon, not helping their cause.
Martin lost it. He's committed a foul. It's a penalty for Kingston College. Or Prince Daniel Smith, rather, the goalkeeper. And KC has a big opportunity now to go in front.
And I just mentioned about them being the architect of their own problems. Poor there from Smith to go across goal. And once he did that, an interception came. He felt he had to bring him down. Had two defenders between himself and goal. And just a rush. Got a little bit anxious there.
There was panic at the back. Williams was trying to bail him out. Collided with the keeper. They lost possession again. And KC, they now have the penalty. They lost on penalties to JC in the Manning Cup semi-final in their last encounter. And Michael Allen will spot this one as KC, they seek to go ahead in this Champions Cup final. They've had so many chances in this one. And maybe, just maybe, they'll be able to take this one. Prince Daniel Smith, being spoken to by Danian Parchment in regards to him staying on that line. He cannot move off the line before the ball is kicked.
But at least one of his feet have to be on the line.
Michael Allen putting the ball right now as it is on sacred ground. And KC looking to get a sacred advantage in this Champions Cup finale. The number 7 to send KC in front. Will he do it? It's saved by Prince Daniel Smith. Having caused the chaos, he denies Michael Allen. And he comes up trumps for Clarendon College.
Poor kick from Allen, but as you look at Smith, just faked to go to his right. But then just went left. I sold the dummy to Allen. He bought it. But a poorly executed penalty. And Smith is possibly, well, not possibly, definitely the most relieved man in this stadium today.
The bad omen from the penalty spot continues. Here's the cross inside. Again, a mix-up at the back. And it goes behind for another corner kick to Kingston College.
Poor communication there. There we see Smith giving a handshake to one of his defenders, but again didn't sort it out quite well. Was looking to take it in there, Smith, and you felt he might have been better served to punch that one out.
Well, if he wants to take it, he should have tried to take it higher.
Yes, he does definitely take it at a higher point because he almost looked as if he wanted to take that into his chest. And that was too low, too close to the heads.
Sixth corner kick for KC. Pearson delivers, whipped inside, and it goes behind. Goal kick to Clarendon College. Ludlow Bernard, will he rue that missed chance? Architected by Prince Daniel Smith, who turned out to be the savior.
Most definitely, he was the one who created it. He was the culprit, and he came back to be the hero on that occasion. But it's a college, been in a few penalty shootouts and having penalty kicks, not been as fluent in it. They've won one penalty shootout, but definitely not so fluent. And we saw there, as we said earlier, Prince Daniel Smith just decided to sell him the dummy deer, faked to go right.
Stayed on the line too.
And might have put off Allen on that occasion. You see in the penalty kick, when you make your mind up, go with it. Unless it is clear that the goalkeeper would have gone down much earlier to the side you've chosen. Still, there's work for Clarendon College to sort out. As I said earlier, middle of the park turnovers, all they're doing a lot of, well, for the most part, they're contributing to it. Give Kingston College credit, as I said. They are closing down the passing lane. They are pressing quite well. But at points where Clarendon College do get on the ball, create the space, they don't quite use them so well. It's one thing to create the space. It's another thing to use it. Is that the moment for them, Clarendon College?
And did KC just lose the Champions Cup with that miss?
They're going to have to bounce back. They do have a lot of time here to do so. Just in the 57th minute of this one.
Long throw taken inside the area. He turns well, trying to get the shot off. Reed lining up from distance. It goes high. Known for the spectacular Omar Reed, and that wasn't too far away.
Not too far away to being a very spectacular goal. We've seen one in another competition this season, not too distant past, but that was a decent strike. He really got hold of it, drove through it with the laces, and he didn't miss by much. That would have been a beautiful goal. Quite brilliant strike there from Reed. And we see why Coach Hyde was furious in the first half. And the fact that he did want him on it, but now Reed goes.
Yeah, Reed is off. Zakia Wilkes coming on for Clarendon College. A little bit surprised by that change?
I'm a bit surprised by it. I don't know if anything to do with the fact that he's on yellow card as well, but yeah, Reed has been one of the better players for Clarendon College. Does not seem to be a change of shape or anything. We see Wilkes there in that left back position.
Again with a long ball, they're appealing for a handball there. Flag goes up for offside against Sheldon Smart.
And Smart there, he was undone by Larman. Should have made the pass a bit earlier, or should have just gone inside, because we looked at it. Smart had drifted an offside position very, very early.
Andre Nicholson in the number 9. He knows his fixture very well, having scored the winner in the Olivia Shield final last year with a spectacular effort. Will history repeat for him and his team in getting by Kingston College? May come into the fray soon enough. CC's number 9. Zakia Wilkes couldn't quite thread that one through.
A moment there when we saw Wilkes trying to make that defense pitting pass, but Clarendon College just a bit lazy there. We saw Smart and Larman taking their own time to get out. Even had that ball gone through, would have been in an offside position.
Kingston College, they know that this is the last game of the season, so they are giving everything on the line. Putting everything on the line.
They really are, because they're working so hard to close down the players from Clarendon College and also block those passing lanes. And when they do get on the ball, they're not bad themselves this evening with the use of the football, Kingston College.
Howell harassed by Robinson. Ball just went out into touch.
And you had mentioned earlier, Donald, that Clarendon College didn't start the game, as they're not always a team that goes out of the blocks very quickly in that first half. But also, I think what we've seen this season is that they've moved the ball much quicker than they have tonight. And against Kingston College, that is looking to commit players high up in the press, this is the night that you feel they need to be doing so.
They don't stop, do they?
Full of energy.
Here's a chance for Ajay Stewart. McCarthy, Pearson. Oh, here's a chance. It's a brilliant shot! Ronaldo Robinson, amazing! Champions Cup final, 1-0.
When we talk about spectacular, that was just brilliant, awesome, wonderful. The minute it left his boot, based on the projector, I felt this one was going to nestle into the back of the net. You're not saving those, goalkeeper Smith. No way you're saving that one. Pick that one out. Pick that one out.
That is one of the best strikes you'll see this season. And Ronaldo Robinson hit that one with so much power. He had the opportunities and he has delivered with a spectacular goal.
Add precision to that one, Donald, because yes, ferociously struck. All the power in that leg was transferred to the ball, but trust me, the placement over goalkeeper Smith, he could do nothing about that one.
Clarendon College, they do not know how to lose. Not this year, not this season. And they also do not know how not to score. Not this year, not this season. There is a first for everything, though.
There is, and that's what history is all about, rewriting it sometimes. And Kingston College here looking to rewrite it in so many ways. They would, if they could see this one out from this position, becomes the first team to win this title twice. And like I said, they know, and you mentioned it just now, Donald, that they know this is their last game of the season. There's nothing to hold back. And with that strike, Ronaldo Robinson didn't hold back.
Well, the boy from Harbourview has given Kingston College a proper view of this Champions Cup trophy.
An unfamiliar territory this season too for Clarendon College, not too often having to come from behind.
The sixth goal this season. What a time to get it.
And he would be happy with this strike. Not just that, because the strike is a very good one. Wonderful strike there, Donald. But because he had gotten some chances in the first half and didn't take it.
Kenmare Studder replaces Jaheim Rose. Hearing that David Chambers may be taken off shortly for Clarendon College. Williams. Chambers. Love the ball over the top. He goes down too easily. And the referee points for a goal kick.
Was smart there, feeling he was tripped up. Good dink over the top. And Larman, it looks like he had a clip of the heel. Look at it here. Beautiful strike here. Just wonderful. And the minute it left the boot, from my position here, it looked like it was going in. And nestled in the net it did.
Oh, here's a chance for Atkinson, trying to win that one against two CC defenders. CC's shaken right now, and Kingston College would want to knock them out. Here's another chance, and he just, well, he lost his footing.
Undone by the turf.
Yeah. CC having an additional defender there in the stadium turf.
Based on what is happening now, coming from Kingston College, they need all the help they can get. You have to give Coach Bernard a lot of credit. Certainly got his tactics right for this one. He spoke earlier that it wouldn't be a tactical battle. Well, he's winning that now. And based on his setup, based on how he has deployed his team today, certainly doing a number here on Coach Hyde.
Jalen Larman is now coming off. Andre Nicholson will enter into the fray.
And Clarendon College today struggled to get Larman in the game. Spoke about it in the first half, and nothing changed in the second half. Just wasn't that attacking threat that we've come to see this season. Not because of his own fault, but because of his team unable to get him on the ball in the advanced positions.
CC, they still seek the equalizer. They've made a number of changes in the hope that they can get something, anything. Granville, Williams. Stoddard was trying to play it upfield. Simpson. Long ball. Granville. Almost. He'll have another chance. Nice touch inside. Howell. Granville sends it out wide. It goes behind for a corner.
And Blair there not taking any chances. He's clearing his line and allowing his team to reset. And we spoke about it as well, Donald. You did mention they do score when they play Clarendon College. So Kingston College will be mindful that this one is not done and dusted yet.
Here's a corner kick. Heads go up. And feet too. But not a proper connection. Zakia Wills couldn't control.
And on that very same note, we have seen Kingston College concede late in game. So, a lot of football still to play in this one.
For Clarendon College, yellow card is going to be shown to David Martin for time wasting, kicking the ball away. Which is ironic because him having to write down the player's name is wasting more time and goes against Clarendon College.
He's allowed to do so, I guess.
Yes, he is, of course. Nicholson to deliver this corner kick. At the back post, Williams is there. Over the head kick, a chance inside the area. Oh, it's headed back in the danger area. Still not cleared properly. Chance for CC! Roderick Granville would want a do-over. He really, really would.
It was a big chance for them to get back in it. And they kept it alive, Clarendon College. For most part here, Kingston College struggling to clear their lines. And once it fell to Granville, he felt on this occasion good back heel and he gets in behind the defence. Just got the shot off, but it was a tame one.
Here's KC looking for the killer blow. It's Stewart! What a save that is! But the follow-up is wide. Oh my goodness! Almost dead and buried Clarendon College, but a strong hand from Prince Daniel Smith proved to be enough.
He needed to make that save to keep this team in it. But just after that save, you felt it fell right into the path of the dangerous Atkins, and you felt he would have put it in. Judge couldn't get his shot on it, but good save there from Smith.
It's end-to-end stuff at the moment. KC looking for the killer blow. CC looking for the equalizer. This is a team that always scores. CC. And they are in the attack in third. Ball played around the box. Granville trying to get a foot in. It breaks three for Pearson, who sends it out wide to Robinson, the goal scorer. He hooks it further up the field, but Clarendon College sturdy at the back. There was a handball there, was it? Yep, free kick to KC, or to CC rather.
And a breather. Yes, into an action here. This, as I said, a very good spectacle we're seeing unfolding before us. I don't think it's done yet in terms of goal scoring. Clarendon College in that attack just now. Seemingly some of their players getting in each other's way.
Long ball. Handled by the KC defence. They'd want to go farther than that. Tajay Williams picks it up. Does well to shield it. Does well to come away with it. Zakia Wills couldn't get there. It's put into touch by Michael Allen. CC with a long throw. It's to come in from Zakia Wilkes. Header, a tame one from Norlan Beckford.
Remaining 15 minutes in this one. Wondering, the big question is, can Clarendon College find a way through? It's a very, very good defensive unit from Kingston College. And it's not just the four at the back tonight that has really worked to keep this Clarendon College team off the score sheet. The entire team has worked hard.
And can they hold on?
You felt when they missed the penalty.
I was just about to mention that.
They had missed their chance, Kingston College. Yeah, but most definitely, they have shown that they still have. When you have that type of kick in your locker, as Robinson showed, you're always in with a chance, missing penalties or not.
Yellow card is shown to Michael Allen.
I think that was a yellow card for sure. He looked to block the path of Granville. I think Kingston College also, they've done well dealing with the diagonal balls and long balls from Clarendon College. They've won most of the headers.
Zakia Wilkes. Granville. Chambers lost it. Ball sent long. Looking for Robinson, or Atkinson rather. Picked up by Pearson. Ball scooped over the top. He's offside, Atkinson.
Yes, it was clearly offside in that play. Pearson has done well in that regard in terms of arriving late. Saw him in the first half hitting one of his shots over the bar, having advance in that area. Yes, Atkinson just drifted offside, leaning into an offside position.
Defender just moved back in time. Did enough. Clarendon College had the desire to win everything this year. This is a trophy that they haven't had their hands on as yet. Playing the ball around. Chambers. Zakia Wilkes. Back to David Chambers. Unlike last year, they don't have a superstar in the likes of Lamar Walker and Nikki Udaly, who can probably turn the game by themselves. And with the discussion about the type of attractive football that Clarendon College they do play, is this proof that they just needed someone to push them over the edge?
Well, it's always good to have that one player who can unlock things. Sometimes, you know, it's a passing game, you try and shift people out, but you need that one moment of brilliance. We saw it there coming from Kingston College with Robinson. Sometimes you need a player who can a dribble pass one or three or four defenders. Not having that in their ranks here, Clarendon College.
Here's a chance for CC. Ball sent inside. The first touch needed to have been better. Ball delivered and headed away by Pearson.
Not been able to get in behind Kingston College via that route with that ball over the top.
Nicholson. King. Gets a return from Nicholson.
It's just that final ball for Clarendon.
Wilkes did enough. Gets a free kick for his team. Zakia Wilkes. Damara McCarthy also hurt.
But again, I can't mention enough. Just have to give commendation to this, to the technical team from Kingston College. As we look at the infringement here committed by McCarthy. He didn't come out unscathed. But yeah, Kingston College really, tactically, they have gotten it so spot on. And the shift for these players to have put in tonight. They have run forward, the transition from defense to attack, and when they do lose it, quickly getting numbers behind the ball.
Damara McCarthy.
Indications there that he may need to be substituted as well.
A brilliant moment from Ronaldo Robinson, wasn't it? What a strike. What a strike that was.
That was a beautiful strike. Just brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. And that was with the right foot.
Yep. Proven to be the difference so far in this one.
Goal even more spectacular, the fact that he did it with the right foot, which is said to be the weaker, his weaker foot, that gives more credence to the strike.
Ball sent inside, the chance, and it's headed over the top. Well, it's a corner kick being awarded to Clarendon College.
As far as Simpson was indicating that it was.
That Steve McCouty has come on for Clarendon College, the number 18. Here's a delivery inside, headed wide of the mark. Oh, what a chance that was! What a chance that was! I think it was Earl Simpson who got the final touch.
That was a good chance there for McLennan College. Flashing header going wide. Time winding down for them. They needed to have hit the target there. Better yet, scoring from that. You feel if they were to get one now, Clarendon College, it would be more so to give them a chance in terms of going to penalties based on the time in this encounter in the 85th minute.
McCarthy has finally been replaced. And Jody Wright comes on. Chance for CC. Granville in space. Granville shoots. And again, the connection wasn't right.
He didn't get the power that he desired behind that one. Good work though from Granville in a very tight space to get the shot off. I have to give him credit. Just couldn't generate the power.
Granville. Stoddard. Chambers couldn't control.
Must be those walks, or anxious walk from Coach Bernard.
The experience of Murray Morrison is on now for Kingston College, the usual skipper, to try and close this game for Kingston College. Couldn't quite reach Andre Nicholson.
Said it all game long, just not being able to get in behind Kingston College defense with the long searching diagonal ball, or even straight down the middle. So strong in the air, Kingston College defense.
Nicholson delivers that one inside, and Warren Beckford trying to get a touch on it.
It was tracked all the way there by Gardner. Good defensive tracking there from a Gardner. Had to be there all the way just to ensure that he provided enough pressure on Beckford.
Allen sends it out wide. Can Casey wrap this up? Allen tries to win it back. Does well defensively. Even if just to eat up a few more seconds.
Anxious moments are going to be there for both these two teams for different reasons.
Referee says play on. Beckford. Bounced inside for Granville, trying to get there. It's headed away. Kingston College should come away with it. They punt it up towards the halfway line. CC still with the possession. Here is Casey now. Can they wrap it up? Inside the box, it's a chance! And it's missed! Dwayne Atkinson, would you believe, him of all persons would miss that chance for Kingston College.
At this stage of the game, it's definitely the person that Kingston College wanted the chance to bury this one, to fall to. And he did well to get by the defender, just a fake to go the other way. And here we see it again. Good work by him, just a stop start. Just couldn't get that curl to the far post.
CC still in it. But they're not helping out their cause at all. Martin.
He's making sure that he wants the attention or the assistance, he gets it. To allowing him to just eat up time. Let's have a look to see why he would have.
Just a slight knock.
And then he induced the second one.
Two sides of the head, ref.
Tell you what, it's nothing for him to be down this long. But I guess he'll tell you it's game management. It is game management. He didn't use that second one. He went for it. But so he's trying to heat up time.
Yep. Rested his head like a pillow there. Meantime, 6 minutes of time to be added on.
Camden College will be happy to see that 6 minute. Not so for the Kingston College team and their supporters.
Well, they have to do something different, don't they? CC. And now they have to do some defending. Overlapping run. Two inside the box. Played across the area. No problems there for Prince Daniel Smith. Game is stretched.
At this stage, that's, you expect that. Just not having been able to find the final quality of this kind of college team.
Ball played long, looking for Tajay Williams. That one is booted into touch.
They have not, as I said, won those first balls. They're going to have to be looking to have players following up with those long balls. They play a lot of those long balls, searching diagonal or straight down the middle. The problem for them is that they don't have enough players coming forward to win the second ball. Clarendon College still trying that. Donald, you say they have to do something different. I'm not seeing it. Two out of the 4 minutes added on here.
Nicholson winning it back. Couldn't get the return ball. Sajar Blair.
You talk about conditioning. I know you mentioned Buckland and College at the beginning of this game. Kingston College has shown that they are a well-conditioned team themselves. But look at Blair marooning down that left-hand side at this stage of the game, having put in the shift that he did during this defensive masterclass from Kingston College.
Almost got through to Atkinson, who's still applying the pressure after 93 minutes. It's his last game this season. It really doesn't matter.
And for once, we've seen the pressure telling on this Clarendon College team. King there had enough time under no pressure. And that's proper game management from the man who seemed to have won this game for Kingston College, Bernardo Robinson. Most definitely a goal worthy of winning any championship.
And he's had his chances, to be honest. He was instrumental in the game even before that shot.
Unless something dramatic happened in this game and you suspect from Clarendon College, you have your MVP in him, and Ronaldo Robinson.
David Martin, as usual, making the most of it. And the KC fans love him for it.
And a bid to win the treble here for Clarendon College, a dying fast.
I'm surprised that their intensity hasn't really picked up, Clarendon College. Williams collects. They have a throw. They have about a minute to go. The KC fans getting ready to celebrate even more. Long throw for CC, headed away by Gardner. Referee tells him to get up. Seconds remaining. Long ball inside the box. A chance at the back post.
And I think that summed up Clarendon College's day so far. I mean, lack of communication from the two players there. I think it was Simpson.
Wills. Oh, decides to take the shot. And his teammates are looking at him with some disdain.
Because that seems to be that. And it took a wonderful strike to accomplish that, this Kingston College team. But we talk about the strike, but I tell you, a complete team performance from this Kingston College unit. Coach Bernard got his tactics right. He set up very well. We saw earlier this season where he didn't employ his attacking players higher up the pitch, seeking to be more concerned with blocking the passing lane. But as we said in this one, they got it right in all departments, Kingston College.
As we take a look at the Powerade power through moments, in the 30th minute, Kingston College had this chance, and that almost proved to be a brilliant finish from the goal scorer, Ronaldo Robinson.
And they came close there. Goalkeeper Smith rooted and got the lucky bounce off the post. That was a sign of things to come.
The delivery from Pearson inside the box. Rajiv Gavin puts it over the bar.
In all fairness, Gavin came to him quickly, didn't have the room to execute, had to take the shot quickly, and just snapped at it over the bar.
That was close. They were knocking, weren't they? And then, comical, Prince Dalian Smith colliding with his holding midfielder, and then tugging at Atkinson, bringing him down inside the box, and a penalty was awarded to KC.
Taji Smith and Prince Daniel Williams couldn't get their bearings right, got in each other's way, and you felt this was the moment for Kingston College.
Well, it wasn't. Prince Daniel Smith making the save from zero to hero.
Zero to hero, faking to go right, then go left, selling the dummy to Allen, and he bought it.
And then Ronaldo Robinson stamped his mark.
Take a bow, son, take a bow. That was off his weaker right foot. And boy, from it left his boot, from my position, I saw it sailing in. And what a beauty to win a championship. They don't come much better than that. Simply spectacular.
Fabulous goal. Fabulous effort. And it proved to be enough for Kingston College. And if ever there was a power through moment, that was one. Take a look at the KFC match stats. Clarendon College, they didn't have enough today. 7 shots, 4 on target. KC, 12 shots, 3 on target. They had 8 fouls. They committed 8 fouls, KC. Clarendon College committed 6. 3 yellow cards were shown to KC, 2 to Clarendon College, who had 3 offsides against them. KC with 1. KC had 6 corners, 2 more than Clarendon College, who had the majority of the possession at 58%. Kingston College are your champions of the ISA Champions Cup, beating Clarendon College by a goal to nil. As we take a look at the player of the game, courtesy of KFC, and is there any doubt what that is?
No doubt at all. Can only be one moment.
And what a moment it was. Brilliant finish from Ronaldo Robinson.
Really a big team moment.
And surprise, surprise, he's the man of the match, Ronaldo Robinson.
All right, with the man of the match here today, Ronaldo, congratulations on winning. This is your final game for Kingston College, and you're walking away man of the match and also champions this evening. How do you feel?
Well, it is an emotional feeling because I wanted to win the Manning Cup again. So, but to come today, we were focused. Last night, we gave our phone. We didn't have our phone none at all. So, I think we come in this match quite ready.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.
All right, Ronaldo Robinson there scoring the winner for Kingston College. Joining me now is Lenny High, Technical Director at Clarendon College. Lenny, this is not the kind of football we're used to from Clarendon College. In the first half of the game, Kingston College possessed the ball most. That's rare for Clarendon College and rare that you didn't score. Was Kingston College just the better team on the day?
No, I don't think so. You know, they came out, I press us, and we didn't handle it well. We still maintained the first half with a nil score, but in the second half when we started to play, that is the time we gave up a goal. So it wasn't working for us today. Some of our top players didn't perform today. It's just a bad day for the team today. You know, we didn't play well today at all.
And to know that you still cannot hold the Champions Cup title, disappointing?
Yeah, man, this one, I can't get this one. I have to just wheel and come again.
Thank you, Lenny.
Yeah, man.
Lenny Hyde there of Clarendon College. Joining me now is Ludlow Bernard, head coach at Kingston College. Congratulations, Ludlow. Yeah, I know you have repeated 2017, lost the Manning Cup semifinals, winning the Champions Cup, the first team to win twice. Congratulations, quite the feat here this evening. Your tactics were on point and you came ready today for Clarendon College.
Yeah, man, definitely, man. Any game against Coach Lenny Hyde is always going to be a challenge because he's a good coach with a very good team. But I think this evening we really planned a masterpiece. I think it worked to perfection. The guys believed in it even when we made a couple of changes to the team and persons were wondering. But it was all deliberate, all deliberate. Everything that was done here today, we knew that we weren't going to have as much possession as possible. We just wanted to be able to pick them off where possible and counter, because counter-attacking is the strength of this team this year. Right, and I really lift my hats off to these boys for a wonderful season. We have played an entire season and we have not lost a game in 90 minutes. Just unfortunate the other day that we were on the other side of the draw. But kudos to my players, kudos to my coaching staff, Coach Watson, who is a tremendous assistant, Coach Jason Henry, managers Jermaine, managers Banks, managers Yaki, Bonnie, Ian, Fortis, Twin, Marlon, everybody. The kitchen lady, Camille, give thanks. This is indeed a gift for the school. I don't know if I should say a parting gift.
I was going to ask you about that, Ludlow, because it sounded as if you were parting. What's next for Ludlow Bernard? Are we going to see you here
Ludlow
next
Bernard
season for Kingston College? Let me hear that.
Ludlow Bernard is going to take a sabbatical, and we'll have to sit and discuss with families and everybody, because I've really spent quite a bit of time here at Kingston College. It's a joy working with these players. I know I said it to the players last night, and I said, Coach, no, you can't go, no, you can't leave us. But they kind of have me soft, so you may very well see me.
Or we may not, but either way, I'm sure Kingston College is grateful for all that you have done for them. Yes. Winning the Manning Cup after 32 years, repeating the Champions Cup. Job well done, Ludlow. Thank you so much.
Really glad. I mean, this victory is very special. A Clarendon College team that nobody thought, that everybody thought was unbeatable. We had a plan, and it worked to perfection.
Thank you.
Thanks again.
All right, Ludlow Bernard, their head coach at Kingston College. He's almost sounding as if he is saying goodbye to the Fortis Institution. But of course, we will hear further news on that. Over now to the commentary team as I go and prepare for the presentation ceremony.
Well, they're a happy bunch there, the Kingston College supporters. They knew this was the only chance for them to celebrate with their team. And they delivered to them today. Well, as you heard there from Coach Bernard, pretty much if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. He definitely planned for this one. We spoke about him and his masterclass today. Really made it difficult for Clarendon College. Played the high press and just deployed his team in a very good way. But kudos to his players. You can have a plan, but if it's not executed, and then you don't have a chance. And those players today for Kingston College, they executed it quite well. Party mood for all the supporters for Kingston College. They have rewritten the history books, being the first team to win this championship twice. And Clarendon College, this one continues to elude them. Well, if he so decide to go, Coach Bernard, then this is a fitting parting gift for him. As Champion Cup, a very prestigious schoolboy football title, and they delivered today as we get ready for the presentation. They're not going anywhere, not at this moment. They want to soak it all up, the Kingston College supporters. And they would have come here today hearing a lot about them not being or coming up against formidable Clarendon College team, not losing a game this season, scoring in every game. A very difficult team to get the ball from. Well, today, Kingston College prevailed. And we go down to Shauna Banks, who is with Raymond Watson.
Yes, thank you so much, guys. Raymond Watson, you did it today. You won the Champions Cup. Usually at halftime, you will tell me all that you have planned and to see it come to fruition here this evening. Doing the repeat of this title, what is this feeling like?
I'm very elated. The entire Kingston College family, we are elated. I can speak on behalf of everybody. The players are happy. And I must say, thank you very much. You're the best presenter. Presenter of the Year Award goes to Shawanda Banks. So thank you very much. Thanks to everyone who supported Kingston College. And I must say, Clarendon College, you played well, but last year you got one over us. So thank you very much this year.
Well, thank you so much for the award. I guess I am a winner here this afternoon as well. You did it today without some of your key players as well. Is this victory a little bit more special?
Yes, it's very special because, honestly, coming in, I was a bit worried about not having especially my son out there. But then I spoke to Coach Bernard and I said to him, this Clarendon team, I had no fear of them preseason, and
right,
I have no fear of them now. Thank you very much.
You. All right. We're going to turn over to the MVP of the Champions Cup, Rajiv Gavin, the captain of Kingston College. He is the MVP of the Champions Cup.
Another question again to Rajiv Gavin, the captain of Kingston College, being named the Champions Cup MVP. Now,
there we have the leader of Kingston College and the most valuable player for the championship, their captain. Rajiv Gavin had an outstanding performance today. And we continue with the presentation. And for the Golden Glove Award, that goes to David Martin from Kingston College. And no surprise that the accolades and the trophies are going to Kingston College. Certainly the champions of the Champions Cup for 2019. David Martin there receiving the award for being the outstanding goalkeeper. So the two goalkeepers there, Asani Barnes, they're joining. Sorry, Prince Daniel Smith there for the Clarendon College team. Both joint winners, it appears, for this Golden Glove Award. So we then have the presentation coming up for a Golden Boot Award. Expect Rajiv Granville of Clarendon College and Phelan Lawrence of Jamaica College. They will share the Golden Boot Award. They lit up this competition many a times with their goals. And there we see Granville stepping up for Clarendon College. Would have been disappointed. The Champions Cup would be the trophy that he would trade this one for. But it continues to elude his team, Clarendon College. It's just a mere consolation for his efforts. But you can see the disappointment edged on his face, Granville. But in reflection after tonight, he will look back at that trophy and be pleased with his effort for the season. And there we have the Clarendon College supporters. Stark contrast to the Kingston College supporters who were expecting. So we now have the medal presentations for the second place team. And that goes to Clarendon College. Not very often we say second place about Clarendon College, but they were undone by a well-organized, tactically astute Kingston College team. And they really played their part in the spectacle tonight, Clarendon College. And we see their captain there stepping up, Earl Simpson, receiving the award. Would have today, and that would have contributed to their downfall. And presentation also how monetary presentation to Clarendon College. They will receive the runner-up check. Runner-up check there for Clarendon College. $500,000 for their effort. Not bad for their efforts. And that would bring a smile on the faces of the supporters for Clarendon College. Not the big one, but still a big chunk there. And the trophy for second place there being presented to Clarendon College and their skipper, Earl Simpson. Still well done for Clarendon College. So often we see finals being cagey and it doesn't live up to the spectacle. They did their part today to help it to do so. And I suspect that the faces will light up for those Kingston College spectators. Clarendon College supporters making their way out, but Kingston College supporters, like we say, they're not going anywhere. They're staying for the entire presentation that is to be made to their team tonight. Led by their skipper, Earl Simpson, Kingston College. All happy faces. And this school would have won this competition before, and as such, would be winning it here for the second time and creating history. First school to win the Champions Cup two times. ...2017 was the first time they lift the trophy. Well, here they are in 2019, collecting their medals. Gardner there was a rock all night. They won pretty much all the aerial ball, everything that Clarendon College threw at them, the diagonal ball, the ball straight down the middle. They were strong in defense, and the entire unit throughout this encounter this tonight was good. Back in their famed purple jerseys, they ditched the white, and a more comfortable you feel in that Pepper jersey. And I'm pretty sure they can't wait to lift that trophy, the Champions Cup trophy. We saw Gardner making his way off the field as the final whistle went to prematurely lift the trophy. Well, he'll get a second chance at it. The proper way, Gardner, to lift the trophy. First, they will be presented with their check. A winner's check of $1 million. And a check from Water 2 for $400,000 also will be presented shortly to Kingston College. And there we see the check also for $400,000, but that's the one, the big one. $1 million for Kingston College in for their efforts today in winning the Champions Cup. They received $400,000 for their efforts. $1.4 million for Kingston College 2019 champions for the Champions Cup.
President of ISA will now make the presentation of the Champions Cup for Kingston College.
The first team to have won the Champions Cup twice. And the Purple Pride reigns once again inside the National Stadium. Against all the odds, the injuries, and what they had to go through all evening. They are smiling now, they are laughing now. Because this is a moment that they will never forget. as the celebrations will continue. North Street is very near. They may just